dear students, in this session we are going to discuss about conservative and non-conservative forces and the concept of potential energy. We will try to understand this with an example. You see, this is the ground, okay? This is your ground and a mass is kept over here. Now, this mass is put on the top of a table, okay? Let us say it went in this path. You have taken this body from this position to here. Let us say this is path 1. This is the initial position IP and this is the final position. Obviously, when you have taken the block from here to here, you must have done some work. Okay, so some work is done in this case. Now, let us say we consider another situation. The block is kept on the ground. And now you took some other path. You took some path 2. And finally you have kept the block at the same position. Like what you have put in the first position, you have put in the same position. So here there is a different path. Here the path is different. Now, east and you are in between, air is there. And air is offering some resistance. Some resistance. You are ignoring that. Air resistance is ignored. Okay. Air resistance is ignored. So, will the work done will be, affected by this path? The work done here is not affected by the path here. You choose whichever path, the work done remains same if you ignore the friction. Okay, how we will see? So, when it is path independent, we call it is a conservative force. When it is path independent, we call it as a conservative force. So how to find that work means, see, this block came to this position. How it came? The block must have occupied some position here, then here, then here, then here, and finally it came over here. That means some work must have been done to take the block from here to here, then to here, then to here. If you add all this work, you get the total work. So let us say you consider a small amount of work. Let us say that small amount of work is dw. dw means very small amount of work. So what is our definition? Our definition is fdx. It is force multiplied by displacement. Let us say a very small displacement dx happened. Okay. Now, if it is path independent, we call the force here, which type of force? We call it a conservative force. So here we will write this as fdx is equal to a new term I am introducing, minus du. Okay, now this is the potential energy. So here you have to remember this very important point. Work done here is, you are doing some work to take the object from ground to the top of the table. You are doing some work. That work will be stored in the body as a potential energy. Okay, carefully here, you have done some work to take this body from the initial position to the final position. You have done some work. So where did that work disappear? It didn't disappear. It was stored in the body as the potential energy. If you are ignoring the air friction, it is path independent. It doesn't matter you take it like this. It doesn't matter it you take it in this way. So it is, position is important. Finally, where you are placing it, that is important. Okay. So here we write a small amount of potential energy, du. This is the formula. Du is equal to minus fdx. Don't forget to put this minus. This minus is very important. Why and how we will try to see. Take the first situation. Let us say this block mass is 10 kg. When you are taking this block from the ground to the top, you are doing the work against gravity. You are going against gravity. that means you are definitely doing a negative work, right? You're definitely doing a negative work. See, what is the potential energy at the ground? See, here dx will be zero, so at the ground the potential energy will be zero. When you take to the top, what will be the energy there? What will be the work done there? So how do you get the work? You have to take the force and multiply the distance. Distance is 2 meters. What is the force? Mg. You know, this body has weight acting downward. Body weight is acting downward. So weight is 100 newton. So 100 into 2, 200 joules. Now here it is zero. And here it is, you are going against. It is minus 200. It is minus 200. So mathematically, if you see, 0 is more or minus 200 is more? 0 is more. That means when you are going in this direction, what is happening? Your potential energy is decreasing. That is why you put the minus. Okay? Let us see the another situation. Now let us see the scenario 2, where the block is kept on the top of the table and you are bringing it down. You are, the block is here. Let me just add this. The block is here, okay, and you are bringing it here. So here, what is at the top of the table, what is the potential energy? What is the work done? See, here also, when you are bringing the block from this position to this position, you are doing some work. You are definitely doing some work. And that work will be stored in the body as a potential energy. Okay? So here, you see that the gravity is acting downward. Here, gravity is helping you. Here, gravity is helping you. Okay, so your force and displacement are both in the same direction, so work done is positive. Okay, now when the body was here, what was the potential energy stored in that? See, when the body was at this position, potential energy is equal to m multiplied by g multiplied by h. This is basically force into distance. See, originally when the block was here, some work must have been done to bring this block here. Just like that, it did not fly over here and came over here, right? So the block was here. So what was the potential energy there? So it was 200 joules. So at this height, 200 joules. If the height was more, the height was even more. See, at this height, it is 200 joules. At this height, 400 joules. At this height, 600 joules. So from here, you brought it down to the ground. And here it is zero. Okay? Here it is 200. Here it is 200. It increased or decreased? It decreased. So that is why you are putting a minus. In both ways, you can understand it this way. You have to remember that du is equal to minus f dx. Du is equal to minus f dx. Okay, and work done is always stored as a potential energy. One very important point when we talk is that when you talk about conservative forces, the total mechanical energy is conserved. The total mechanical energy is conserved. Okay. So here I have written some more points. Take the second situation where air friction is considered. In this situation, what happens? This is your path 1, this is your path 2. Earlier we have not considered the air friction. Now we are considering the air friction. What will happen? When more path length is there, means more friction. So here, when you consider friction, the path you take is important. It is path dependent now. See, here less amount of work will be done. here more amount of work will be done. More amount of work has to be done because here friction is more. Friction is opposing you. Here less friction, less opposition. Here more friction, more opposition. So your work is getting affected. So in this type of situation where it is path dependent, you call it as non-conservative force. You call it as non-conservative force. If it is path dependent, you call it as non-conservative force. If it is path independent, you call it as conservative force. So usually when you calculate potential energy, we ignore the air friction, and the forces we use is path independent. So for the calculation of potential energy, you remember this is a very important point when we are going to discuss about gravitation chapter and class 12 maybe electricity and all these chapters. This potential energy concept is very important. So you have to understand that it is path independent. Okay. We are going to talk about is collisions. Collisions means, you know, a car hitting another car is a collision. So in this figure you can see I'm talking about a term called head-on collision. Okay, so there is a mass, this is one object, this is another object. They have got some initial speeds denoted by u1 u2, and let us say m1 has hit m2, and after hitting, maybe they went, m1 went backwards and m2 went forward. There are many situation scenarios. Okay, so this type of collision is called so head-on collision. Initially the object is here. You can imagine this like initially a car is there here, another car let us say is coming from this direction, and they hit each other. It's a head-on collision. Head-on collision means front-to-front collision. Here this second object can be in rest. Let us say in this example this M2 can be at rest, but M1 is coming and hitting it. Okay, so this is a collision. Now collision are of two types. It is elastic collision and inelastic collision. But before getting into that, we need to understand few very important points. During any collision, you need to understand this. During any collision, we need to remember two points. Point number one, the linear momentum is always conserved. The linear momentum is always conserved. Conserved means the value is constant. We have studied about linear momentum. How do we calculate momentum? We take mass and we multiply with the velocity. So that means if I have to find the momentum of M1, I have to take its mass and multiply with its velocity, not with the second object velocity. So the first point is always linear momentum is conserved. That means the meaning, the mathematical meaning is initial momentum or the sum total of initial momentum will be equal to sum total of final momentum. So let us understand this. Let us say there is a mass m1, its initial speed is u1. Let us say a mass m2 is there, its initial speed we are denoting by u2, but it is at rest, and this mass m1 is traveling in this direction. It goes and hits m2. What happens? This mass m1 comes to rest, it stops there, and mass 2 starts moving in this direction. So is this a head-on collision? The answer is yes, it is a head-on collision. So here initial speeds, if we talk about, the initial speed of m1 is u1, initial speed of m2 is u2, and the final speed of m1 is v1 and m2 is v2. So the meaning of this statement is you have to find the initial momentum of the system. System means the entire thing will be called as a system. This entire thing is a system. So what is the initial momentum? You have to consider the initial momentum of the mass m1 and initial momentum of the mass m2. It is m1 u1 plus m2 u2. And what is the final momentum? you have to consider the mass of m1 in the final stage and momentum of the mass 2 in the final stage. It is m1 v1 plus m2 v2. And you have used a term called it is conserved. Conserved means this sum total is equal to some constant. Both are equal and they're equal to some constant. So you can equate these two. This you can apply whether it is an elastic collision or an inelastic collision. So linear momentum is always conserved. Now the second point is, in this whole situation, kinetic energy is also involved. Why? Because this mass is moving, right? So when a mass is moving, it will have a kinetic energy. You have studied in class 9 and 10th also, kinetic energy is given by half mv square. So it depends upon the mass, it depends upon the velocity. So here, this first body has some kinetic energy. The second body also has kinetic energy. It is at rest, means it has no kinetic energy, it is zero. This total system has a one kinetic energy, let us say 100 joules. Okay, and then this body one comes and hits body two. What happened? This kinetic energy, initial kinetic energy, can be equal to final kinetic energy. That means initially 100 joules was there of the system, and finally also it is 100 joules. Then it is called, if it is conserved, we call it as elastic collision. If it is not conserved, it is inelastic collision. You can see this example, a car 1 is coming and hitting the car 2. So initially the whole system has some energy, let us say 100 joules. But when they hit each other, some energy is lost in sound. You hear a sound. What happened? From where that sound came? They hit each other, some energy of the system was lost. So this type of collision is called inelastic. If there is a loss in kinetic energy, you refer to it as inelastic collision. So it will be given in the question whether it is an elastic collision or inelastic collision. Depending upon that, you have to frame the equations. But basically the concept is this. So the first point is, the linear momentum is conserved in both the cases. But in inelastic collision, the kinetic energy is not conserved, whereas in the elastic collision, it is conserved. What we have studied now, just to mathematically, if you want to understand, during the case of collisions, the sum total of total kinetic energy in the initial stage will be more than the total kinetic energy of the final stage. Okay, how you see in this example, when I said that the car is coming and hitting it, it's a case of collision. So initially, let us say the system energy was 100 joules, then some energy was lost in sound, so final energy was 80 joules. So there is an energy loss in collision. But when it comes to explosion, the final kinetic energy of the system will be more than the initial kinetic energy of the system. It is reverse of this. Just remember this condition. Okay, in explosion, the final kinetic energy of the system will be more than the initial kinetic energy of the system, because energy is supplied here. Energy is internally supplied here. But in both the cases, the initial momentum of the system will be equal to initial momentum of the final momentum of the system, whether it is collisions or explosions. Collisions and explosions are not same. There are two different things. Okay, so whether we talk about collisions or we talk about explosions, the initial momentum of the system will be equal to the final momentum of the system. The initial momentum of the system will be equal to the final momentum of the system. So that is not going to change. But this equation, the kinetic energy, whether it is conserved or not, that depends. If it is conserved, we call it as elastic collision. If it is not conserved means not constant, we will call it as inelastic collision. So we talk about inelastic collision and we talk about explosion also. Explosion is not elastic. Explosion also is a type of inelastic only. Okay, so in explosion, final kinetic energy will be more. In collision, initial kinetic energy will be more.